How are you?
Fine, Raphael. Let me hear what's on your mind. Far away.
Hey, Dougie, I'm going to say something, and listen to me, because I know you're going to be jumping on me. I was watching the game yesterday, the Golden State Warriors, and everybody's talking about how transcendent that team is. And I had an epiphany. That team is nothing else but a younger version of the Portland Trail Blazers. That team that was coached by Rick Adelman that went to 2 straight NBA finals. The only difference is that team is younger, but that team is less athletic and less skillful.
Now, you're right. Well, hold on now, Raphael. You think this Warrior team is not better than that Portland team that lost 2 finals?
Yeah, but I'm saying that it's a less athletic team. And it's the same thing. It's a photocopy of that team.
No way. That's not. I mean, listen. Portland had, you know, Cliff Robinson and Terry Porter and Duckworth. I mean, that team is not as good as this team. Here's the one thing I would say about this team. As I've said 2 things. The passing to me is overrated because you know, you could pass the ball until the cows come home. When you have 3 guys shooting 25 footers who make them all the time, the passing looks good. So I think that's a little overrated. With their passing, half their possessions, if you watch, somebody comes down a court and fires up a 3 or he goes one-on-one a la Durant, and there's no passing involved there. And number 2, I think, no, he had a great second half last night. He did a great job. I think Curry's a little overrated. He is an horrendous, and so is Harden. They both stink on the other end of the floor. I mean, they have destroyed Curry defensively. He's not a good defensive player. Not that he has to be. A lot of great players offensively and not great defensive players. He is not. And Harden stinks defensively too. But I think Curry is a little overrated. He has not played great in the finals. He had a lot of trouble with Kyrie Irving. When they didn't have Durant last year, they lost the year before that badly, 3-1 lead. See, if you're an all-time great, and you got a 3-1 lead, even if Green gets suspended a game, and you are that kind of player, if you're Curry, I know he's a little bit of a thing, but if you're that kind of player, you cannot lose that series. And a year before that, when they beat Golden State in 6 games, they had no business losing that. They almost lost that series, too. They won the last 3 games. They're down 2-1, and Love and Irving didn't even play, and he had trouble. So I think he's a little overrated myself, but not. I can't go crazy and compare this team to the Portland team. That's not fair. Here's Huck in Missouri. He's with us here on Mad Dog Unleashed. Huck, good afternoon. How are you today?
I'm doing pretty good. I think Raphael got a little early start on the smoking dope there with that Portland deal. That was a little much.
That was a little rough.
Mr. Chris, you gotta tell us about the golf before you go home.
I want to hear a little about the golf.
I will.
I will get into that. Go ahead.
Now, I want to give a little Elvis comment, if you don't mind. I was watching an interview that Sonny West gave several years back, and yep. Elvis is one of his number one bodyguards.
Right.
And he was saying that about a year before Elvis, in 76, they were out in Vegas. This was when Elvis was in really bad shape. Said they were in a hotel room, and it was him and Colonel Parker. And said Elvis was just in absolute bad shape. You know, he was completely stoned out of his mind. He was urinating on himself. I mean, just in real bad shape. And he had to go on stage in like an hour and a half. And Sonny said he told Colonel Parker, he said, there's no way I'm going to allow Elvis to do this. He needs help. He needs some rest. And he said that Colonel Parker looked at him and said, I don't care what he is. He's going to be on that stage tonight. All that matters is that Elvis is on stage. And you know, 3 days after that, Sonny West was fired 3 days later.
Wow. I did not know that story, Huck. You're right on button. Good boy there. All right, number 2, NBA. Go ahead. Let me hear.
Listen, this is garbage. These 6 games, these conferences, is absolutely unwatchable. I mean, all blowouts, you know, it's tough. And I'll tell you what I'm going to do from here on out. I've tried to watch every game from start to finish. I'm not going to do it anymore. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the game on at about the end of the 3rd quarter, and I'm going to see what the score is. And if the score, you know, is 6-8-point game, I'll go ahead and I'll stay with it. But I am not turning the game on until the end of the 3rd quarter. And if it's a 15-point game, I'm just going to go right to the next channel.
Well, you know,
I just cannot invest time. I can't invest 2 hours into something that's in the last 6-7 minutes. I'm going to cut it off. I can't do it. I ain't got the time. My time is actually somewhat valuable.
Now, that's a good point. There is some truth to that. Well, if that's the case, you may not put the Celtic game on tonight. I'm not sure how competitive they'd be in this game. But I do understand where you're coming from. 13 in front of the hour here on Mad Dog Unleashed.